Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to discuss about the online written test pattern of Accenture. Okay, Accenture will be conducting exam in two patterns, off campus and on campus. The written test pattern of off campus will be conducted by AMCAT, and if you are on campus, then your exam will be conducted by Meritrack. Okay, and coming to the written test pattern of the off campus. First, there will be questions on verbal ability. There will be 25 questions on verbal ability, and you will be given 25 minutes. Okay, and cutoff is 18. Cutoff means minimum you have to get 18 marks to get passed in verbal ability, because this is a sectional cutoff. Okay, every section you'll be having a cutoff, it's not like overall cutoff. Okay, so make sure you'll be at least getting 18 marks to get promoted to next section. Okay, and coming to aptitude, under quantitative aptitude, they'll be asking you 24 questions, and out of 24 questions, you have to have the cutoff of minimum 17. Okay, 17 of your questions should be minimum correct in order to get promoted in aptitude section. Okay, and for this 24 questions, you'll be given 35 minutes to solve, and aptitude will be little tough comparing to other verbal and logical. Okay, so make sure you prepare well for this aptitude. And coming to logical reasoning, you'll be asked to solve 25 questions, and the cutoff is 16, and you'll be given 25 minutes to solve this 25 questions. So you'll have 1 minute to solve one question. And basically for logical reasoning, you will not have the sufficient time to solve the questions. So make sure you think well, you solve the questions fast, because most of the candidates will be running out of the time with logical reasoning. Okay, and coming to on campus, for verbal ability, they'll be asking you 20 questions, and time will be given as 20 minutes, and cutoff will be in between 12 to 14 based upon the competition. Okay, and coming to quantitative aptitude, they'll be giving 15 questions, and 15 questions will be given 15 minutes to solve, and the cutoff is just 10 marks. Okay, and coming to logical reasoning, 20 questions will be given, which you need to solve in 25 minutes, and the cutoff is 12 to 13. Like, the cutoff may be 12 or 13 based upon the performance level. Okay, and in on campus, Accenture will provide you the sufficient time for each and every section, but logical reasoning will be little critical, so you need to concentrate more on logical reasoning. So make sure you prepare and practice more and more mock tests for logical reasoning, okay, in order to crack the written test. Now coming to verbal ability syllabus for off campus. Okay, this is the syllabus for off campus verbal ability syllabus. First topic is synonyms. Synonyms are nothing but meanings. Okay, they'll be giving you a sentence, and they will underline a word, and they'll ask you to find the synonym of this word, or they may give a word, or they'll directly ask you to write the, like, choose the synonym of those word, of that word, within the given options. Okay, so okay, next is antonyms. Antonyms is nothing but opposites. Okay, and synonyms and antonyms will be little difficult in written test. Okay, so make sure you practice more and more questions, and try to get a logic to remember a particular word, so that it will be time saving for you during the exam. Okay, and next topic is error identification. Like, they'll be giving you a sentence, and you need to identify what error is there in that sentence, so that comes under error identification. And next is sentence correction. Like they'll be giving a sentence and there'll be some error in that sentence. You need to find that error and you need to correct that error, okay? And options will be given, okay? Because these are all of multiple choice questions, okay? Next, they'll ask you to find subject verb agreement, okay? This will also be difficult. Tenses, okay? Change it into past tense, change it into present tense. These sort of questions may be asked, or they'll ask you to find in which tense the question is given, okay? And after tenses, they'll be asking you comprehensions. Like they'll be giving you the sentences or the words which you need to give the comprehensions, or idioms, those sort of things will be asked. And the last topic is vocabulary. Under vocabulary, you need to be so perfect in order to save your time, because it consumes more time if you didn't practice well, okay? Now coming to on campus verbal ability syllabus is, first they'll be asking you the reading comprehension. There will be an advantage and disadvantage with this topic, because if they give you the small paragraph, it will be so easy to solve out the questions. And sometimes they may give 20 to 25 lines of the paragraph, which will consume much time than expected. So practice more and more reading comprehensions, okay? Next, critical thinking. They'll be asking you a situation, or they'll be asking you like problems or some cases of critical thinking. So it will be basically hard, okay? Next, they'll be giving you a sentence and they'll be asking you to correct the sentence, okay? So that comes under sentence correction. And here, as off campus, in on campus also, they'll be asking you synonyms and antonyms, okay? These are compulsory questions for every year. And para jumbles, okay? This is also most prioritized topic under verbal ability. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching my video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon and share this video with all your friends. And I have done many videos on CRT, reasoning, verbal and quantitative aptitude. So don't forget to watch those videos. Thank you so much for watching this video, and all the very best for your exam.